here at scrutineering. They're just checking over the cars, making sure we're all safe and good to go. And yeah, they always like me. I'm a pretty likable guy. But yeah, that's good.
We've got all three cars ready. They're prepped. They're probably had more man hours to turn on than any other race that we've been to the last few years. We come here with one thing in mind, and that's to win. And hopefully that Travis and his new turbo car, myself and my turbo car, and Dad's actually stepped into the old 13 car, V8 Jimco. Left the poor old Porter at home.
That boys had a bit of a debate without me there one day, and I come down and this was being prepped instead of my Porter. So we've got this. It was sort of, I was just told.
We put together a lot of really talented guys to come to Fink this year. We've got, as I say, we've got 10 or 15 blokes that are very knowledgeable in their own certain areas. Obviously, Murray's spearheading the whole lot, and they'll be certainly looking to him for all the answers. But we put together a really good group of guys, and thank them very much for coming along.
Pretty much put on display for all the kids, and Maddie's and all that. And pack them up about 10 and get up early tomorrow and race prologue.
I'd be happy with anywhere, if I'm within the top 10, I'll be happy with that, because I think that this is the sort of race that even if you come 10th, you've still got a good chance of winning the race, as long as you don't get caught up in too much of that dusty stuff. There's going to be 30 other guys that are going to be doing exactly that. There's Danny Orrick. There's Chris Coulthard. There's new man Paul Gilbert. You've obviously got the Peter Kittle Motorsport team with Dave and Andrew in their two cars. They'll be good. Out this morning with we obviously tried to have a good cracking prologue. We had three cars that were all very strong and very well prepared, and we went and did recce, and we changed a couple of little things on the car to try and make it a little bit faster in some of the spots on the what seems to be a little bit flatter prologue course than what the actual track's going to be like. We made some changes, obviously they worked. We ended up on pole, which is a good thing. We're only half a second faster than my brother Travis, so he's second, so we got OBR cars first and second, which is just amazing. It's still setting in. The old V8 car that Dad had his first ride in today, he's going to be starting next to Buddy Crow back in, 17th position. After prologue, we discovered that the Albans gearbox we run has seemed to have destroyed itself inside. And so we're putting a gearbox in it, we're going through the steering. It'll be ready to go, but it's just very, very unnerving to think that it can't go 8 kilometres, so how's it going to go 500 kilometres at the end of the day? But we'll look after it, and hopefully it does make it. Getting a bit nervous now. It's really interesting feeling looking up there, and no one else is in front. Something I've never experienced before. Actually, I've never even come close. So it's a really good feeling.
How's it going, Trav?
Yeah, good. Had a good run yesterday in prologue, and cycling up today for today's race. Yeah, basically it's a new car, so we don't want to push it too hard. We don't know what it's capable of doing yet. Got to be pretty smart about it this year, I think, and. Don't want to go out there and try and kill the car straight away. Hopefully it will work out. We'll get down there and back.
Looking forward to something severe now. For me, it was the first go in a big buggy, and that was a bloody... Well, obviously, I'm still not there yet, but it's, yeah. I just get towy before a race. Real towy, like a corn-fed racehorse.
Course itself, we've got a couple of sections down pat. We haven't tried to remember the whole course. It's a bit hard, but we think we've got some sections down pat, and there's a lot of silt out there, a lot of dust. The track, as most people know, is the roughest in Australia, if not in the southern hemisphere. It's made up of hundreds of kilometres of, or a couple of hundred kilometres of the roughest terrain in the country. I don't think we've got any time to waste. We can't be holding it at 90%, I think we're going to have to be 10 tenths the whole way, because there's going to be 30 other guys that are going to be doing exactly that. I mean, if they break, they break. We prepared them not to, and that's the best thing we can do. We can't do anything more than that. So when the green flag drops, I guess we're just going to have to be 10 tenths.
We know the car, how the car can, how fast it can go through the whoops. We still need to do a bit of suspension tuning and a bit of tuning on the Motec too, the car, to get it running right. But they did a great job with the new car, along with Murray at the workshop, and the car straight out of the box was obviously a winning package. So all credit to those blokes and at Jimco and the boys at the OBR workshop. The weekend was looking pretty good, and about the 190k mark we blew a transmission, pretty spewing, because we had a pretty big lead on the rest of the field and Dave Fellows, and also Bo blew a sensor or something on his motor. So really disappointing, but we thought we were going pretty steady, pretty good pace, trying to conserve the car as well. But these things happen, and we just got to learn from it, and hopefully get a bit of luck at Griffith.
We started 15th or 17th something. We'd had a shocker of a prologue. We're a bit disheartened to find Trav down the track, but we'd got a fair bit of dust and traffic on the way. We didn't know Bo had broken down. We thought that Bo was sitting in the pits waiting for us to get in, but that wasn't the either. He had problems with his computer. We came in, I think, ninth, and overall had a faultless run except for the dust. The dust was just like following B-double trucks just in the dust. It was just horrible. The rate that those boys were going at, the breakages are inevitable there. Just a thing, it's part of the sport. At the level they're trying to race at, that's going to come all the time. There's three of us starting pretty much at the same time, so it's going to be probably a bit of dirty dancing, do a bit of pushing and shoving, and try not to get in that same predicament we had yesterday with the dust.
That was sensational. I have never had an experience like that. I've seen it, but to actually sit in there and do that is just incredible. I'm gonna get myself one for spare parts.
Well, if we could come back in sort of a reasonable time, and we've all had our problems, other people have their problems, we quite easily could come up a fair few points on the board. Hopes come in the first five. Yeah. That's 5 grand. Huh? It's a grand a place, isn't it?
Yeah.